Hey, Kevin. What are you doing?
Well, I got a request on YouTube the other day for a plate welding video. I'm assuming you mean it's like a 3G or a G3, something like that for your certification, where you weld a vertical plate back together again. Well, I don't have a vertical plate, so use your imagination, okay? What I did was I chamfered this edge about half of the thickness of the metal. So if this was a quarter inch thick, I went in an eighth of an inch and went out an eighth of an inch. So it has an eighth inch chamfer on it. So I've still got an eighth of an inch worth of flat surface to mate up with my other piece. And then I have a eighth inch deep, quarter inch wide chamfer to weld back together again. We see here's my flat surface, and they just go together like that. And you see the chamfer in there that my weld has to go up into. Let's jig it up. Sometimes you get to cheat, like using a magnet. So now my edges are nice and flush again. You just may believe these are here. But this surface is nice and flat and straight across. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead and just tack it in a couple of spots, and I'm going to go behind it and weld it in the back. A little, just to help keep things still, so I can get my magnet out of the way. Because of the strength of the magnet, it's going to screw up the arc on the TIG. It's literally going to take the arc and pull the arc off towards the magnet itself. So I have to be able to get this out of here first. So let me just tack it together and we'll get to it. Okay, so now I've got this just packed together, so I can get my magnet out of the way. Now, because I have to go so deep down inside that hole, but I don't have a lot of material left, because I've chamfered half of it away already, what you normally do is go behind it and run a bead up the back of it. Let's do that next. The amperage up on the welder just a little bit so I can get decent penetration. Watch your eyes. But now we got the back of it welded, just kind of tacked together. This will help keep everything straight and neat and square. Okay, so now we're just going to run a bead up through that chamfer. Penetration because the amperage is too low. So let me go turn that up a little bit more. So we got a pretty good weld in the bottom of our chamfer. So now we'll go ahead and turn the amperage up a little bit more. Get a little better penetration to make up for the weld that we just put in, and also get off into our plate on either side, and then get another good bead across top. I'm going to change my tip, my tungsten, because I touched in the molten metal, so I contaminated the tungsten. So I'll put a different one in. Let's try that again. Pay attention to your teacher. Hope you're back. See you later.